What's up, everyone? Oranga Gaming here, and welcome back to Annette Island. Decided to start this video off with a couple cinematics of the power plant and water treatment plants that we had made in last week's episode. Today, we're going to be working on a recycling plant in order to handle all the trash that this game needs to have handled. The only way for this game to work properly, like having power plant and having water, you gotta also have trash collection. The way I see it, with this being a Indian reservation, I feel that a recycling plant would be more appropriate, more green than, say, a ordinary dump. I don't know if that's exactly how it is there or not, but from a assumption point of view, a recycling plant seems to be the best bet. What you saw a little bit before is I'm having trouble with the move it and anarchy tools. They were fighting me. Either I'm not using them properly or they just do not want to work for shit. I shouldn't curse. I'm sorry. I curse so much in my other games that in real life, it's hard not to. But I should not be cursing on this game, so I apologize. In any case, basically, with these two buildings, I feel like they're the initial collection of trash and refuse. So I wanted them to be first so that, you know, if you were to be the one to drop stuff off for one reason or another, you can do so quickly and get your butt out of there. And then everything else, they all seem like a type of buildings that are more for processing. More of an internal processing from the looks of them. So put them together. I kind of had a general idea of what I wanted to do. Granted, it all happened like last night at like 2 o'clock in the morning where I got the thought. And I was like, oh, hey, I'm going to go jump on this. Now, this is coming out basically 2 days late. So I apologize for that. A lot of that's just because I'm lazy, admittedly, but also because I'm easily distracted. So I was really distracted with a new game that I'm playing that I do want to make a series on. I actually mentioned it in another video, but I'm mentioning it here as well. You will be seeing a new series coming out, not this week because I will be gone over the weekend, but hopefully next week I can, or the week after, I can start on a new series. So with an area like this, it's probably going to be all concrete. So that's why you see the concrete everywhere. And right now I'm laying out a few containers because I want to do this a couple times, primarily here in one other spot. But when I deployed, the mission that we were on was a retrosort, basically military-esque trash collectors. Not really trash per se, but it was more like military-related trash. So I wanted to kind of do a small one here as a recycling plant, so it seemed like a good place, good fit. I wasn't really feeling these containers. So what you'll see me do later on is I'm going to change them out with some better ones that I found on the workshop. So I'm not a huge fan of all the containers, mostly because the sizing just seems really off. Like they all seem like 40 footers when really most containers are 20 footers, but the 20 footers in here look like 15 footers. I don't know. It just doesn't look right. Which is why you have two rows where there's, you know, kind of stacked right next to each other, just trying to simulate the longer container, which again I end up changing that out later anyways. I do continue to use the vanilla containers, but I had to use the other kind, the downloaded ones later. So just use some of these jersey barriers to kind of block off the area so that, you know, you're not getting a whole lot of traffic right next to it or whatever. Just kind of like isolate the area a little bit. These generators I'm putting down, the intent is for them to basically be light generators. I didn't find the right type of light on the workshop. That doesn't mean it doesn't exist. I'm actually been having a lot of trouble finding very specific things on the workshop. So if you know what I'm talking about when it comes to generator lights, you know, like construction generator lights, let me know down in the comments with like maybe a link or maybe the right thing to look up. So I can go and add that. I'll add the lights at the very end. I won't don't record it, but you'll see it when, you know, in our final cinematics. But I wanted to definitely feel like it's being worked. I mean, fairly organized. I mean, this is a really small type of retro sort yard, so can't do too much with it. What I'm doing now here is I am laying out the parking lots. I end up deciding not to go too much in depth on this particular set of parking lots, primarily because I spent so much work on, which you don't see a lot of that because I didn't record it, but a lot of work on the parking lots for the power plant that I didn't want to spend, you know, 5 minutes of video working on, or of the final video, just working on a parking lot. So I decided to make this one fairly simple. And the other reason behind it is that, like, with the power plant being especially that it's oil and steam, and considering the location, I feel like the owners of that workplace would put a little more effort into making it like green space and making it look nice in order to kind of like, hey, look, we're not just dirty. We're trying to be clean and all that kind of stuff versus the recycling plant. It's all it is. It's the whole purpose of a recycling plant is to be clean. So I figured, you know, they would be a little less inclined to put a whole lot of effort into beautification. But they are big. Both parking lots are huge. And, you know, I don't know how anybody feels about big parking lots, but the way I see it in real life, a facility this big, like with where I work, our building's huge. It has like 6,000 people that work at that one place. It's probably actually more than that, really, but it's a lot of people that work in one place. So the parking lot's got to be big. And it's huge. And I figure places like these, as big as they are, they're going to have big parking lots. So I end up, really the only details, these grass curbs with bushes. I tried a bunch of different stuff and none of them were really working. I tried trees and, you know, with the grass curbs being so small, I didn't feel like a tree was really appropriate, even if it was small. So I ended up going with the vanilla bush. I figured it felt like it worked the best for the most part. I may go back to it later and choose something else or find something else on the workshop to go with, but that's something I might do later on. I'm not doing that anytime soon. So here are those containers I was talking about. Excuse me. Where I just kind of changed them out. Like I said, I used some of the vanilla ones as well, just to kind of have the difference in size. When I put these stacks down here on the side, the ones I'm doing right now, when I rotate the camera, I was like, oh shoot, they're crooked, let me take those out. And then I was considered putting them back down, it's straighter, but it was just such a narrow spot that it didn't work really well. Now this is going to be a little bit of me searching. The reason why I'm searching is these containers aren't really typically moved by cranes, not in this type of an area. They're moved by a container handler. Could have sworn I had downloaded one a long time ago, but couldn't find it. Come to find out it's not under container handler, or what we call in the Army a wretch. So I had to go download one. It was a small one. It worked. initially until later on I ended up finding the one that I initially downloaded like a month ago when I was setting up all the assets for this, but I want to make sure it was there and it was, you know, taking off a container or maybe even putting one on for it to be shipped. I do try to use Move It to lift this green container up in order to stack it on top of that blue one, but I couldn't get it to work. So if there is a way to do it, let me know down in the comments and I'll go back in there and adjust that. What made me think of doing that was, again, I'm going to hopefully not say his name wrong, but I probably will. Trust me, I understand my last name gets butchered all the time, but I saw Biskweigelhausen do it on one of his videos, and I was like, that's awesome. That's perfect. That's what I need. I don't need to go into the asset creator to do it. I can just do it, you know, that one time I want to do it. Couldn't figure it out. So, again, if you know how to do it, let me know. Just laying straighten out. All I'm doing here is just straighten out the concrete edges, the surface painter. I just was not getting it to work the way I wanted to, so I said forget it. And just went with the concrete brush and just kind of straightened all the edges out. They're not perfect, but once you put the fence in, you don't hardly notice them not being perfect. Now this opening here, what I decided to do is run a road through it. And because I didn't want anybody really using it, I use traffic precedent to basically disallow all movement except for exiting trucks. And the way I see it, that kind of makes sense from a logistical standpoint. Now back here, I am doing another trailer storage parking lot thing, whatever you want to call it. I'm sure there's a technical term for it that I don't know, but I don't know it. I do have a little trouble getting these lines to be quite straight, at least as far as the road goes, since you do see the road texture a little bit. So I put down another road, used the lines that are in the middle to kind of line me up. They're not perfect still, but they're closer to being perfect than they were beforehand. I like using this concrete road a lot for parking lots because it has that little bit of a like driveway where it breaks up the curb and it kind of has a little bit of almost of a lip. Probably not really, but I mean, we're talking about a video game here. It looks like a lip. It looks like a driveway, and I love it. So I've never gone into a parking lot that didn't have that. Now, if I can figure out how to do an asphalt parking lot, that'd be awesome. But I don't know how to, and we'll have to figure it out later. I can tell that they're a little crooked, and maybe I'll jump back into it another day to kind of straighten it out a little bit. I will say this, and this is where I'm not very, where it shows that I'm really new at this, other than the sound of my voice sounding really nervous, which I am. I am running out of breath because I don't really talk this much in one shot. But as I'm making these, the second one is looking not quite as good as the first one. Not that the first one looks great. But I decided to leave it because really, even though I'm not doing this perfect, and yes, I don't want a lot of like tire marks and stuff like that, I do want it to be look relatively perfect and dress right dress and clean. But it doesn't have to be 100% perfect because really nothing's 100% perfect. I mean, if you look at my work's parking lot, it's nowhere near perfect. Even though they just redid the lines, it's still kind of jacked up. But it is what it is. That's just normal for us humans. So, but at this point there's only a couple minutes left in the time lapse, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and give you some guys some music, finish out the time lapse, and I will see you guys in the real time mode, and it'll be a first one. So hopefully you enjoy this so far and enjoy the next bit. Until then, I'll see you there. Hi there, and welcome to the first of hopefully many real-time segments of our build on Annette Island. So basically what this is going to be, there's not going to be any building, but the idea is to basically kind of showcase what I've done so far and run through a couple of ideas that I have that I haven't done, and show you a couple of the off-camera stuff that I have done, and see if anybody has any ideas or suggestions for things I can do in the future. So first I want to go ahead and go over what we did here in this area, and most of the off-camera stuff was like just some of the minor details. I wasn't sure how I liked them, so I wanted to play around with them a little bit. Did get some of these bollards in. I like how these two kind of frame the fire hydrant. Added these cones in, probably unnecessary really when you think about it, but these bollards should probably be cones. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. I didn't do a whole lot of off-camera work on this one, which is probably why this was such a long video. Actually, let me go and play this. And let's do that. There we go. I am considering, however, rebuilding the water treatment plant. Not that I don't like how this looks. I think it came out pretty well considering. In my research of looking at recycling plants, actually, let me just go back here. I saw one that's actually fairly close by that looks way nicer and cooler, if you will, than what I had built here. So I'm considering possibly redoing it. But until then, we'll leave it as is. With the recycling plant, however, most of the off-camera work was really here in the parking lot. Put some of these recycling receptacles here, although they were probably unnecessary there. Probably could do more like parking or something, but I didn't totally fill it in like I did with the power plant, but I think it looks all right on its own. I thought about adding some more detail here, and actually, maybe I will do a little building here. Let's get out of this and back into here. I really like this random thing. Keeps me from overusing just one thing, although I'm not going to use you or you or you, really. I do want to do some of the things over here. Like so. And no. No more. But, yeah. Okay, you guys are really not playing well right now. There we go. Make this look a little more full and more used. I think that'll do it for now. Whoops. I don't know what that was. My bad. Love this. I have the sound effects going. If you guys want me to remove that, I can. For now, we'll leave them on. We'll let you guys decide what sounds better to you. But anyways, as far as off-camera detailing did, I added these cones to kind of break up the monotony of the concrete, and I really like the contrast of the orange and white to the black and gray. Added this little police station, which I did quite a few of them at the power plant, in order to, this is kind of like our facility security office. Figured with this being recycling plants, not as likely to be broken into, but it could. It's going to have some sort of security. Added these containers here. I'm not entirely sure how I feel about them. Same thing with, like, pretty much all the detail right here. I like it, but I'm not sold on it. Add a little more trash to roughen the edges of these piles. Added a few more cars, a few random stops, random bits of like stuff. What I was going for, trailer here. And then, excuse me, as I was going through here, kind of seeing what else I could do, I thought about, if we're going to have this sort yard that's taking off and putting on containers, we might have some empty trailers. So I went ahead and put some empty flatbeds over here. And then here's the lights that I was talking about. They're ordinary street lamps, but my initial thought was to use like the airport lights, but they're like way huge. They came up like twice as tall, which seemed entirely unnecessary to me. So I went with these for now, clipped them through the generator so it looks like it's a part of the generator. Added a couple more in here to kind of light up this area. This is more or less kind of the same idea, of course more compact with what I had done on deployment. It's really easy tour, nothing to be proud of per se, but I'm glad I did it. I was tempted to try to get out of it somehow like a little bitch, but I'm glad I didn't. And so this area here, I'm gonna just move on. These pipes, I'm sure as I was putting these down, you guys are going, whoa, what's that? Why are you putting that there? They're pipes. It doesn't make any sense. They do, if you think of them as not pipes, but as, bumpers, if you will. This seemed like a really good place to put them. We have them at my works docks. I'm assuming some more guide the trailers into position than to just let them kind of go whatever. So I wanted to add that in here. I probably could have added it maybe here or something, but one spot's good enough. I'm sure some of my piping choices are a little strange and don't really work very well in reality, but that's what I decided to do. Like here with the ladders are kind of blocked off by the pipes, but I don't know, we'll figure it out. So I'm not entirely sure how I feel about these planter boxes with the bushes, the vanilla bushes, but I haven't made up my mind. Anyways, moving on. I don't know if there's really much else to talk about in this area. If I do remake the water treatment plant, I'm probably going to build more around here, kind of extend it out, make it a little bit bigger and more just spread out. But also in this section here, I have it filled with trees right now, but I am considering possibly putting a bunch of more tanks. Still not sure if that's good English. Here, because, you know, a facility like this that runs on oil and it refines and uses it as power and all that other stuff is going to have a hell of a lot more tanks. The one I drive by every single day has 3-4 times as many tanks. So I'm thinking maybe here would be the location for something like that. I haven't made up my mind, but that's kind of the idea. So one thing I don't think really got seen in the time lapse of last episode is this overpass I had built. It's a real simple, straightforward overpass, and I think it'll do the job for now, especially since I don't have any like people here living. But I really, really liked how the flowers here look. It kind of dresses this up a little bit, and I might do something like this more often, maybe a little bit more detailed than that. But as far as these little nodes here that connect all this, I might work on it. I haven't made up my mind. It's a lot of extra details and take super long for, in probably longer than somebody who knows what they're doing. So I don't know. We'll see. But that's really about all the time I have for this segment here. So what I'm going to do now is go ahead and leave you with a few cinematics of our recycling plant. A couple more of the power plant, because I am really proud of how it came out. And hopefully with being gone this weekend doesn't mess me up too much with getting back to you on the next episode. But if it does, it'll come out. It's going to be late, probably, just like this one's really late. But I will do the best I can to be a little bit more in time and on a better schedule and stick to the schedule. Anyways, this has been another episode of Annette Island from Oranga Gaming, and thank you for joining me. Till the next video, take it easy.